The evolution of organogenesis in mammals. Extant mammals show a great diversity in body form. Humans and dolphins, dogs and bats, elephants and mice. At birth, they already resemble the anatomy of their adults. The characteristic shape at birth is established in prenatal life, long before birth. Although a human newborn is very different from an adult, a human can be distinguished from its closest evolutionary relatives already at birth. Using an evolutionary framework, meaning the tree of mammalian life, we studied the development of the organs and general anatomy of a variety of mammalian species. Here we see embryos of deer, human, and rabbit as examples of placental mammals. We documented the timing of 123 discrete embryological features belonging to the limbs, the arms and legs, heart, eye, ear, and snout development. A change in the timing of those characters, either earlier or later appearance, results in larger or smaller organs. The specific combination of that sequence of events characterize species, and the differences between deer, human, and rabbit form as development progresses. A study of this kind was extended to 77 mammalian species, and with this information, we reconstructed the organogenesis of the last common ancestor of all placental mammals. We answer the question, how did the first placental, which probably lived around the time of the demise of the dinosaurs, develop in uterus? It was born after almost 4 months, and weaning took place after a similar period of time. We then made comparisons with non-mammalian species to better understand what makes placentals unique. For marsupials, monotremes, and reptiles, we also documented the timing of, again, those 123 developmental characters and reconstructed the ancestral organogenesis. We found that several fully terrestrial land vertebrates opened their eyelids long after birth or hatching, which shows that the young are blind for a long time and need help to survive. Based on those findings, we reconstructed the life history of the last common ancestor of all fully land-adapted vertebrates, the amniotes. We reconstructed 10 eggs for the amniote ancestor and found that the hatchling had closed eyes, just like most mammals at birth, and the eyelids opened after 28 days. In this long period, the young was blind, and the mother must have had to feed and protect the young.